The Corvette C8 is one of the most popular cars of the moment, and the launch of the new Z06 will only further increase its popularity. Now, there are of course good reasons for this, and a key one is the price to performance ratio. I really envy my US viewers when it comes to car prices. However, and you probably guessed where this is going, the C7 is also still around. Many argue that this is the last real Corvette, but those voices seem to have settled down a bit now people got used to the C8. In fact, it became quite silent around the C7, but I think that they still offer tremendous value for money. And to show you why, we will have a look at the Stingray, Grand Sport, Z06 and ZR1 market and compare the price development in those markets to the one in the C8 market. Let's start by having a look at today's market and some of the peculiarities of the C7 market. Over here we have the C7 market as of October. The model year is displayed on the horizontal axis and the price on the vertical axis. You can also see that the colors display the different models. We have the Stingray, the Grand Sport, the Z06 and the ZR1. Naturally, the Stingray is the cheapest of the bunch, as it has a median price of $55,000. And this is $15,000 less than the median price point of the Grand Sport, which is $70,000. For the Z06 you need to add another $19,000, and the ZR1 is really in a league of its own. It has a median price of $170,000. Market supply follows the same ranking as the price levels. There are a bit over 2,000 Stingrays for sale and only 49 ZR1s. Supply for the Z06 and Grand Sport sits between 700 and 800 cars. Now, compared to other markets, there are a few things which make the C7 market quite unique. The model year sensitivity is low, the mileage sensitivity is low, and the prices overlap to a large extent. The first point we can already see from this graph. The black axis over here show the median price point for each model year and each model type. You can see that the older cars tend to be a bit cheaper than the newer cars, but the difference is extremely small and much smaller than in other markets. On average, the price drop between each model year is only between 3 and 4%. So if you're shopping for one, be aware that for the price of the oldest car, you can also almost get the newest one. And this really contrasts to cars like, let's say, an AMG GTR or a McLaren 720S, where 1 or 2 year old cars are heavily discounted. Now, the second thing which makes this market special is the mileage sensitivity. Also, this is extremely low. Over here we have now the same picture as before, but with the mileage on the horizontal axis instead of the model year. And this reveals that, with exception of the ZR1, the depreciation per 1,000 miles is extremely low. For the Stingray, Grand Sport and Z06 this sits between minus 0.3 and minus 0.5% per 1,000 miles driven. And these are excellent scores. They are, for example, a lot lower than the ones for a 911. This doesn't go for the ZR1, as the mileage sensitivity is quite high over there, with an average of minus 1.2% per 1,000 miles driven. Now, all of this means that, unless you get a ZR1, you can drive the car for quite a bit before its value will drop significantly. And this is not always the case with these performance cars. Finally, the third point which is quite unique for this market is the price overlap. Over here we have the price distribution for the C7 market, and you can see that prices range from $30,000 to $290,000. If I zoom in a bit, so we lose the top end of the market, we can see that there is an extremely large overlap between the models, especially between the Stingray, Grand Sport and Z06. The cheapest Grand Sports are priced below the average price of a Stingray, and the most expensive Grand Sports are priced above the average Z06. Also, you can see that there is a significant overlap between the Stingrays and the Z06s. And this means that we can identify a price sweet spot between $55,000 and roughly $75,000. Within this price range, you can choose between a Stingray, Grand Sport and a Z06. Of course, at $70,000, it's likely that a Stingray will have a lower mileage than a Z06. But still, the choice is yours. You don't see this extreme overlap in, let's say, a 911 market. Now, if we look a bit more towards the right-hand side of the graph, we can see that there's even a small overlap between the Z06 and the ZR1. If you are shopping for a high-spec, low-mileage Z06, you could also consider a ZR1. A car which is in a different league, not only mechanically, but also when it comes to future value potential. And speaking about this value development, there is a lot going on. But before we have a look at that, if you like this video, please support the channel by clicking on the like button below. Thank you. You can, by the way, also follow me on Instagram. I don't post so many pictures over there, but I frequently post updates on car markets in my stories. But now then, the price developments. Over here we can see the development for the Stingray, Grand Sport, Z06 and ZR1. Let's start with the obvious one, the ZR1. Look at that, prices really soared. A bit under a year ago, we already had a look at the market and discussed that from a theoretical standpoint, it would make a lot of sense that these cars would go up in value. Back then, we already saw that between June 2020 and January 2021, prices increased with 4.5%. Since then, the price increase accelerated as values went up with 22%. Hence, between June 2020 and now, prices increased with 30% or $40,000. And that's a serious price increase. It is then also an increase which is statistically confirmed, and this means that it is unlikely to be the result of chance. It's then also among the highest rates I've seen on the channel. Now the prices over here are asking prices, not selling prices. As far as I'm aware, the latter ones are not freely available. However, if we have a quick look at the auction data from Bring a Trailer, then we can see first of all that the trend in asking prices is roughly in line with the auction results. There are only a few data points available, but there seems to be an upward trend. Additionally, we can see that since July 2021, cars are selling around $160,000, and this is very close to the median asking price of $170,000. Normally, the difference between the two is slightly larger. So this means that price-wise, there is not so much to gain for you as a buyer if you are buying it from an auction site. If we go back to the price development graph and have a look at the other cars, then we can see that Z06 prices dropped by quite a bit between August 2019 and July 2020. But this is not a real price decrease, and the drop what you see over here is a bit misleading. In August 2019, there were simply a lot of new cars for sale, whereas there were almost none for sale in July 2020. I looked at the same picture, but then only for the used cars, and this revealed that prices didn't change for those cars in this period. It is, however, from July 2020 onwards that prices started to increase. First slowly, with 3%, and then more severe with 13%. So this means that between July 2020 and now, prices increased with 16.1% or $11,000, and that is in line with what we see in the rest of the market. It's however a bit more than the increase in the Grand Sport market. Prices over there increased with 12% or $7,600 in the same period. Stingray prices, however, moved more in line with Z06 prices as they went up with 22% or $18,000. And that's interesting, right? This namely means that in terms of value for money, the Grand Sport gained some ground here. Z06 has moved a bit away from them, while Stingrays moved closer to them. So what do these price developments mean then for future price developments? That's an interesting one, right? When it comes to the Stingray and the Grand Sport, I expect them to follow the used car market trend. This means that I think it's fair to expect a gradual reduction over time. And if you want to know why, have a look at this video over here, which will update you on the latest price developments in the used car market. Now, especially for the ZR1 and the Z06 to a lesser extent, the price trend might deviate from the market trend. The cars are simply more focused, special, and production for the ZR1 was of course limited. Some of that we can already see in the price trend over here. As I said before, the increase in the ZR1 market belongs among the largest ones I've seen on the channel. It's on par with the increase in the 996 and 997 market. Hence, given the severe increase and the rarity of the car, I think it would be strange to expect a sudden decrease. There is, however, one thing which is causing me to doubt that statement. The supply development. Have a look at this graph over here, where we have the development of the supply, median mileage and median model year. The red line shows the development for the ZR1, and if I zoom in a bit, we can see that supply first dropped from 21 to 13 cars. In this period, prices increased with 4.5%. So perhaps the supply decrease only affected the prices with a lag of a few months. Now if we translate this to the most recent supply surge, then this might mean that the price trend will flatten or even turn. Look at that increase. Supply went up from 13 to 49 cars. What is going on here? This is just speculation, but given the specialness of the ZR1, it might be so that many ZR1 owners bought the car with the idea to face minimal depreciation or perhaps even to make a profit. After all, it's what they call a last of its kind car. All of these owners saw prices rise during the last year. You couldn't escape it, as also your everyday news outlets reported on it. And this in turn might have motivated a larger than usual group of owners to put their car up for sale. Now we saw before that the cars are actually selling for these prices, so I don't think that's a matter of just advertising the cars with a too high price. But I'm doubting if there's enough demand to support the supply increase. If we look at the other cars, we can also see supply increases, and this indeed fits with the market trend. Especially during the beginning of this year, we saw supply decreases, and now we are starting to see the first increases. This in turn would also fit with a future flattening of the upward price trend. And with that, let's shift gears a bit. Let's see now how the price trends compare to the one of the most popular car of the moment, the Corvette C8. Let's insert that one to the graph. We can see now the C8 market in purple, and this shows that the median price for a C8 increased with 13%. In other words, compared to the other cars here, the increase sits on the lower side. Moreover, this price increase is actually driven by the newer C8s which are added to the market. In the used C8 market, we saw a first flattening of the price trend, but we are not going to go into that now. You can find all about that by clicking over here. Now, in terms of price point, I think that this graph shows what a great deal the C7 is in today's market. Of course, the C8 is a very different car compared to the C7. But with the current price premiums, you can buy two C7 Stingrays for the price of one C8 Stingray. Moreover, you would have $20,000 left if you would spend it on a Z06 instead of a C8. Now, things become even more interesting when we think about the new Z06. Prices are not yet disclosed, but I think it is reasonable to assume that they will start at around $90,000. At that price point, there is nothing which can beat it in terms of value for money. But if we learned anything from the C8 Stingray introduction, then it is that demand is insanely high and that it is higher than supply, pushing prices far above MSRP. So I think it is unlikely that Z06 prices will stay at MSRP. They at least will be above the current C8 prices. So a median price point between $120,000 and $130,000 is not unthinkable. And at that price point, it's almost twice the price of a C7 Z06. As I said before, they are completely different cars, but I think that this makes the current generation look like quite the bargain. And with that, let's wrap up and conclude. The C7 shouldn't be forgotten, as it has a lot of going for it. The market characteristics for the Stingray, Grand Sport and Z06 are favorable. Model year and mileage sensitivity are both very low. Also, prices are quite favorable as they are still relatively low compared to other cars and especially compared to the C8. Prices developed more or less in line with the market trend, and I do then also expect that they will follow that trend in the future. The ZR1 is a different story. It looks more like a collectible car market than the other ones. Market characteristics are a bit less favorable as the mileage sensitivity is quite high, but this fits with such a market. Value-wise, I think they were an excellent buy 1 year ago. I also showed this then in my ZR1 market analysis. Current prices are however quite high, as they are up by 30%. Given the specialness of the car, it's not something which is immediately worrisome. Yet, we saw the supply increase significantly, and this might indicate that the price trend will start to flatten. I think it's always a good idea to buy a car first and foremost because you love it. And if you love a ZR1, then a car from the lower end of the market might still be a good buy. However, there are also people who buy such a car predominantly for financial gain. And if that's you, I would maybe rethink a ZR1 purchase. And with that, we arrived at the end of the video. Now, if you enjoy these data-driven analysis of car markets, but would have liked to see the analysis for a different car, let me know down below in the comment section for which car you would like to see an analysis. Once there are enough requests for a certain car, I will make a video about it. Don't forget then to subscribe and click on the notification bell so you will be notified when your requested analysis goes live. As always, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next week for a new video.